Hello there, everybody. You're the audience. My name is Supersonic Blur, and welcome back to the next episode of our Pokemon Star Sapphire Nuzlocke. Last time, we made our way along Route 111, Route 112 South, Fiery Path, and now I've found ourselves here on Route 112 North. Well, the first thing we have to do is pretty much just go straight on in with a trainer encounter. So let me go ahead and pull up the trainer list. So I've got that available to me. Draw Air 112. Find Route 112. There we go. Easy peasy. Right, now this first trainer here is, by the looks of things, it's really bad. Do I really need to worry about it? Not really. So let's just go ahead and walk straight on into him. I'm not such an amateur that I'm gonna take it easy just because you're a kid. Okay, well, why are you fighting me in the first place is the main question. But Jalen, yes, Scrafty. Go ahead and send that on out. Level 45 with Intimidate, High Jump Kick, Scary Face, Crunch, Facade with a Chesto Berry. So there we go. Attack has fallen, but we've both fallen in our attack, so it doesn't really matter a whole lot. As for the move that I can use, Aqua Tail's probably going to be fine. Same team as last time. Literally nothing has happened between episodes because, well, nothing can happen. It does land the High Jump Kick, but it's not very effective. So we're in a pretty good spot. So Aqua Tail again should do me pretty good. Maybe high roll, maybe low roll. Oh, just kill it. That'll do fine. That'll do fine. I'm always concerned if I see 50 dead on, because I'm like, was that a low roll? Was that a high roll? Where is that supposed to be? Because I don't calc all of these. The only ones I really calc was, like I said, the wind straights, which I was looking at, and also the gym leaders. What do we got here? We got some raspberries. Very nice. I'll take a couple of those. Raspberries, thank you. A Purzenberry of 3. We will take you as well. Thank you very much. Not too bad. And then I think more raspberries. Very good. What do they do? I think they might be Pokeblock stuff, which is unfortunate. But back, let's have a look. What are you? What are you, berries? What do you do? What do you do? Enhance coolness and can cure confusion. Okay, well, also as well, this brings up a fantastic point of this here is Route 112 North, which new encounter, new routes means that we now have the option of getting something. So let's go ahead and try and get something that I believe was a Phanpy. So let's see what else is here that we might want.
Later that same evening.
Okay, it has been about 30 minutes before this son of a bitch turned up. Now, I haven't got my repel on. I have been doing this so long, I actually stopped using my repels because I was concerned that I would run out. And in all honesty, I don't know whether or not I would or wouldn't have. Now, I just need to slowly go ahead, bag, and thunder, check what moves this thing has. That's it. That's the next thing. Check what moves. Kangaskhan. There we go. I can't spell Kangaskhan to save my life, but I've got its moves. I know that it's a normal, yep, normal female. We are all fine with that. What I want is the move pull. Level 37. So I know what it's got. Crunch, Dizzy Punch, Chip Away, Mega Punch. Okay, I'm fine with actually being, with leading. No, I want to lead with Zeus. In this instance here, we want to lead with Zeus because we want Thunder Wave. And then the objective's fairly simple. Just, well, chip away at it, really. And I'm just moving, like, the controller. I'm barely moving it. Like, literally, I'm doing that with it. I'm resting my thumb at a slight angle. Because I'm so scared. Okay, Zeus is in. We'll go with Thunder Wave. Click that. Now, what we can do is calc, just in case we do need it. X, Y, I want to show only the imported sets for you. And it's Kangaskhan, not Kangaskhan. I always think it's Kangaskhan, but it never is. Anyway, you are level 37. I want to look at Zeus. Okay, assuming that this thing has max Eevee, assume zero in HP, it will assume zero in special defense and zero in defense. The best thing I can do is hit a tri-attack, which if tri-attack crits, will kill it 85% of the time. I don't think I've got any other option there. And if we look at catch calc for this, then we've got you. We'll just open you. Kangaskhan, full HP, 37. Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. Status, paralyzed. We have, if we go Ultra Balls, we got a 27% chance at doing that. So if we got a 27% chance of throwing it and getting it the Ultra Balls versus hitting an attack, which if it crits, 1 in 16 times the 87% chance, it's probably fine to hit it at least once. This is, of course, assuming the absolute lowest rolls, like 0 HP, 0 defense, and it crits. That's fine. That did like half. We're fine here. So now it's on like 40% in an Ultra Ball. That gives us an extra 22%, practically doubling our chances here. So we're going to go ahead and Pokeballs, get the Ultra Ball. Get in the Ultra Ball, please. Part of me is just concerned about how long it took to get this damn thing. Literally, I stopped the recording and then restarted it. Because it was taking so long on this. Like, that's how long it was genuinely taking. I'm not kidding. This was like 20 minutes. Like, it's physically gotten darker because of that. But still, Kangaskhan is here. And would you believe we're only just beginning of the episode? This is mostly me reminding myself because I've been here for 25 minutes or plus. Like, ugh. Anyway, giving a nickname to Kangaskhan, yes, we shall. Rhea is a goddess in the Greek mythology, the titaness daughter of the earth god Gaia and the sky god Uranus, Gaia's son. She is the oldest sister of Kronos, who is also known as a consort. In early tradition, she is known as the mother of gods, and therefore is strongly associated with Gaia and Cybele, who have similar functions. Got a mother of gods, mother Pokemon? Like, come on, you gotta give me something here to work with. Still, Rhea has been transferred to Midgard. Well, they'll get on with the other Pokemon we've got. Still though, now that we've done that, we can leave. Other Pokemon that were here, Hitmonlee, Hitmonchan, Sockthrow, Tyrogue, Phanpy, and that's like it. There's one more I'm missing because I can't think of it off the top of my head, but I can almost guarantee you I saw them. Oh yeah, Machoke, or Machop, whichever the baby one is. Would you believe I saw all of those first? Before that turned up. But still, it turned up, so that's fantastic. Now, what we've got is another trainer. Now, we may be looking at this going, oh, is there a level 111 north? Is there a new Pokemon? No, there's not. Even if there was the option for it, it's the same set of encounters. It's the same set. So, no extra luck for us. However, what we do have here is kind of a tricky fight. We do genuinely have a tricky fight coming up ahead of us. We have Ace Trainer Wilton. So this is going to be, I'm basically looking through here. And first things first, we've got to obviously just heal everyone up. So let's just go ahead and Aura and Berry everybody up. Keep them all healthy. And by that, I mean Jotmunganda and Zeus. So looking at this then, let's see what it leads with. So you lead, yeah, you just lead with, okay, so if that's the lead, we probably want to do this to lead here, and that'll be, we'll use Taylor Jr. to lead. I keep thinking that I can switch there, but you can't, but no, we want to lead with, probably Taylor Jr. here. The objective is going to be fairly simple. We want to kill almost all of these as quickly as possible. The general idea with this trainer is everything's got like baton pass, everything gets really strong, and the idea is that you just get this horrible messy situation where there's a billion stats going through and you haven't got a chance in hell of dealing with it. So we're going to go ahead and take on Ace Trainer Wilton. So yes, they're gonna leave with a Smeargle. Level 46, Moody, Spore, Quiver Dance, Ingrain, Baton Pass, and a Focus Sash. So, we know for a fact it's always gonna have at least one shot, but we want a Flame Charge here, so it's always faster. That's gonna be useful, especially if Moody becomes a problem for us. So it didn't die straight away, but it used straight into Baton Pass. Okay, was not expecting a straight Baton Pass, but here we are. Vaporeon comes on out. Water Absorb, Acid Armor, Scald, Baton Pass, and Wish with the leftovers. I do not believe there's anything that I can really do to fight this one, so what we're going to have to do here is go ahead and switch to Zeus, because the last thing I want to do is go in against a Scald. That's just a bad idea for us, so we just simply won't. There's Acid Armor, which ups its physical defense. However, that will not help against a Discharge. So Discharge goes off. This should Oko? Oh, not quite. Not quite. That's scary, because now its physical defense is rising a lot. I don't know whether or not this trainer has any potions or not. Yes, they do. So there's the Hyper Potion. We're still okay, because we're using special defense, so you can raise your physical all you like. We've still got some good physical defenses that we can deal with. I don't know if it's going to go for another one, or it will Baton Pass here. I reckon it will probably maybe Baton Pass here. I don't know. But Discharge goes off. This is fantastic for us. And this is a really nice thing about this fight in particular, is it's really difficult if this trainer gets off a load of these switches and then has a really strong Pokemon to end it. However, if it does, if it can't get those through, then it's just absolutely screwed. Hydro Pump. Do we want Hydro Pump? I mean, it's only 80 accuracy. It hits like a truck, but don't get me wrong. But I feel like with the set that we've got here, Hex, Brine, Toxic Strikes, Toxic Spikes, and Sludge Wave, I don't want Hydro Pump. Like, I'm not, like, Kurokamui is not here to absolutely decimate through with that. It's there to stall and, like, have status effects. So we'll keep the old moves for now. Yes, we can give up on learning Hydro Pump. We do not need to worry about that, Kurokamui. So next comes in is a Sylveon. Pixelate, Stored Power, Calm Mind, Hyper Voice, Baton Pass. This one, we can Flash Cannon, I believe, because Pixie or Fairy is weak to that. With a Pixie Plate, means that Hyper Voice gets Fairy Typing. And that's very good for us. It's using Calm Mind, but we're more than okay to tank this. We did more than 50% of its damage, of its HP, so this should work without too many issues. Good job, Zeus! Whew, good job, Zeus. Very nice, very nice. So that's Sylveon, Vaporeon, both of which taken care of. Wonder what comes in next here. That's going to be an interesting question, because I don't actually know. Espeon! Magic Bounce, Calm Mind, Stored Power, Substitute, Dazzling Gleam, and Leftovers. In this instance, again, it's fairly bulky to pretty much everything that we have to deal with. So the objective is going to be fairly simple. It's Flash Cannon and do it as hard, you know, just hit as hard as we can. About half. It does go for a Substitute here. We know we should be able to break the Substitute, which is very nice for us. It gets one Calm Mind off and an extra one of those, so Flash Cannon should be fine. Oh, you son of a... Right, Hyper Potion. Fair enough. Worst comes to worst, I guess we can go, like, Jörmungandr or something like that. Maybe just, like, absolutely decimate it, hit it absolutely as hard as we can. So, you've done that. We can go ahead and use Flash Cannon again. It'll put you at about 50% HP, which we're fine with. That's fine. It's gone for Dazzling Gleam, which is not going to hit us hard at all. Yeah, not very effective at all. Does get leftovers, so that's fine. If we hit it with Dazzling, like, we don't need to hit it with Dazzling Gleam. We can hit it with Discharge as well, so we'll use Discharge for the PP save, just in case. But Discharge will take us down. That's fantastic. Not sure whether or not Discharge was more damage or not. Probably should have checked that. That would have been smart. Could have dealt with that a little bit sooner. Still, Zeus is level 53 now, and that's good for us. What comes in next? What's the line with Magnet Rise? Keep the old moves. Magnet Rise is not something we need, not something we'll use, so we won't. Okay, next on up is a Scolipede. Speed boost, iron defense, substitute baton pass, and steamroller with a black sludge. This thing, don't really have a whole lot to worry about for it, so we're just going to hit it with a flash cannon. I don't know if steel is super effective against poison, not sure, but... Okay, that was a lot of damage. Speed boost is going to suck. Not going to lie, that is just going to be very difficult for us to deal with, but discharge, we'll throw that out. He uses steamroller, it's not going to do anywhere near enough damage to us. The only thing we've got to worry about is whether or not we flinch. Shouldn't have said that. I should not have said that, because now it's speed boosts, and now it's going to go for it again, and this one just becomes ridiculously fast, so steamroller, we're fine. All we got to do is not flinch, and we'll be fine. Or we'll flinch, and that'll happen. Speed boost again. This thing's just going to be super fast, and we don't really care. We'll just discharge, okay? It's using baton pass. This is where things are going to get real scary. Please. Please. Yes! Going to Togekiss! Air slash Thunderwave Roost, baton pass, and a citrus berry. That's what I wanted to see! That's what we wanted to see! That's the scary thing. With all the other five, everything's about this sort of like baton passing into a Togekiss with Serene Grace Air Slash. Fuck that. Fuck, that's difficult. That's why I was like, let's go with Discharge then. Because there's no way on this fucking earth we're dealing with that Air Slash. Just no. Not happening. But no, that's taken down. That's fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. Next up's the Smeargle. Spore, Quiver Dance, Ingrain, and Baton Pass. It's that low already. You know what? Let's use Tri-Attack. We don't use it that often. It's not a stab, but it does the job. It does the job. Whew. That was a fun fight. I like this fight. I think this is a fantastic fight. Because it's everything's got baton pass, so it's this idea that, you know, if they build up too much momentum, you're in trouble. The problem is that you take out one of their Pokemon when it's setting up, and bam, it's over. But that was, oh boy, that was quite the challenge. So let's go ahead and Auron slash Leperberry everything up, so that's all good. And now, with that done, we can go ahead and move on further up here. Oh, we have this guy. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I can smell it. I can smell it right here. The scent of adventure. This has got to be a secret spot. There'll be enough space in here to build a crazy super place. Well, my name's not Auron. Yeah, great. I didn't want to really meet this guy. Hey, kids, you want to go and climb that tree and make a secret spot with me? No. Oh, my young trainer. Please don't say yo. What can I do for you? Leave me alone. What do you mean I didn't ask for anything? Bet your heart did. No, now that's getting a bit... Now, no need to be shy. After all we managed to meet... Just go away. Put her there. An overborn and 25 years old. Spent the last 11 trying to find myself. Just a vagabond in search of dreams. Wandering around Owen, trying to find a place where I really belong. Probably in jail. That's right, a super secret base. You don't know about secret bases. What kind of life is that? Too sad, little bro. Time for a little lecture from Uncle Owen. Oh god, he's calling himself Uncle. You know what? I don't care about. Thank you for secret power. I'll take that. Don't want to know anything else, buddy. So yeah, secret bases, I really could not care less about them at all, in the slightest. So yeah, just please don't make me go in there. Please don't make me go in there. Please don't make me go in there. Oh god. How is this inside a tree? I don't know, but I literally could not give a rat's behind about this at all. Just let me go. I don't care about you. You're as bad as... hang on. Can I go away? There we go. Just go away. Just go away. Go away. Go away. I don't care about you. Fuck off. What are you doing? I don't want this. Just... Just let me go, please. Let me go, please. I don't care. I don't want to show a secret base to anyone. I can't show a secret base to anyone. Just... Why are you adding me on Facebook? No! Just let me go, please. Let me leave. Let me leave. I don't care. Is it over? Can I leave now? Please. Please. Oh, thank Christ for that. Right, yes! So that's done now. What have we got over this way? We have a cut path here. Oh, yes! I remember this area. This is where we've got the lovely old woman who's like, come and rest here if you need anything. And I'm like, thanks. We've got... What have we got over here? Gotta have a look. Yeah, we'll go this way. I think we will stop and rest just in case I've missed anything. What do you want, old lady?
Oh, my dear, you want to put me exhausted? Yes, rest here.
Okay, we've rested here. Now that we've rested here, I should probably... I really should go and burn Horus. So, I think I'm going to go back and actually go to Route 1. Wow, that regrew fast. I regrow back to 112 North and just burn Horus, because it would be probably a good idea if I did that. Because in any upcoming fight, I really need that guts-boosted facade. So, it shouldn't take but a moment. Right, and with that done now that we have Horus burnt, all I gotta do is go ahead and, give you back the silk scarf, because that's a hell of a thing. That's the wrong one. Silk scarf, give you that. 20% more damage on facade. It's kind of silly. I am kind of using Horus as just like a one trick right now, and that's a little bad, I'm not gonna lie, but at the same time, can you really blame me? It's what the Pokemon was designed to do. It's just what it does. Anyway, let's go ahead and take on our trainer here, who is a lovely little fairy girl. Fairy girl, CC. Or Fairy Tail Girl, CC. Sending out a Mawile. Level 46 with Intimidate. Iron Head, Play Rough, Fire Fang, and Sucker Punch. So, kind of an offensive little Pokemon right there. Pretty okay. But Flame Charge, yeah. So I'm thinking Flame Charge probably going to do good damage. Good damage? Pretty good damage? Yeah, pretty good damage. And our Speed Raises, just in case we needed it. It's going to use Play Rough, but we'll avoid the attack. And that's fantastic. And we'll just Flame Charge again because we don't want to do anything else. Yeah. There we go. Very nice. And our Speed Raises again. Which helps us for the next Pokemon coming on in, which is a Celebi, level 47, Natural Cure, Calm Mind, Ancient Power, Giga Drain, and Psychic. If I weren't a betting man, I would switch out because of the Psychic. However, I'm not. So you know what? I'm just gonna hit that Flame Charge. Hit the Flame Charge. Go on. Survive it. Oh shit, it did. Oh shit, it did. Oh thank fuck, it went Calm Mind. Okay, no, that's fine. Grass Psychic, we can deal with that with many other Pokemon at this point. So we're just gonna go ahead and hey Horus, come out here. Come out here right now. Come out here right now, please. Probably should have switched to a Korokomui first, because then it wouldn't have hit you and the Psychic wouldn't hurt. This could hurt. This is gonna hurt. Oh no, the burn! Oh! Holy fuck! Right, Facade kills here. I believe in Facade. Yeah. I believe in Facade. Oh, thank fuck! Right. Actually, I shouldn't have gone on a Kurokamui, because if that had gone for the Psychic, that would have killed me. Fucking hell. I should have gone to Zeus and been fine the whole time. Jesus Christ. I'm an idiot! But it's okay. You know why it's okay? Because that's what makes things entertaining. My stress and heart palpitations are your entertainment. So let's go ahead and just, I'm so sorry, Horus. I'm so sorry. I almost got you killed. But here, you get the good stuff this time. None of that fucking berry crap. You get the good shit. Alright, you get one berry. But you get the good shit there. You get the Oran berries, mate. Like, you get all the good shit, but my god. Alright, let's not be stupid next time. Because the next trainer we will have to fight is, after we get these, a Rossberry. I'll take a couple of Rossberries, I guess. I can harvest one of those, so that's fine. Yeah, can't pick up any more Rossberries. We've got Nanab Berries. Don't ask me what a Nanab Berry does. I don't know. But I'll have those. It's been planted. Next up here, we go up here. And we get ourselves a... well, first of all, we're going to ignore that trainer. And we will go ahead and get an elixir. Very, very useful. Let's look at what else this thing knows. Okay, yeah, we should be okay to just hit this thing. So, come here, you. Come here, you. Yes. Huh? What would you be doing in a place like this? Could it be that you two are lost? No, I'm not lost, Dion. I'm sorry, Dion. But they do have a Linoon. Gluttony, level 45. Slash double-edged rest belly drum with a Rossberry. Let's see if we can't proc that Rossberry for you, buddy. I suppose, though, with Stab, Rock Smash versus... I don't know if Rock Smash would do more or less. I think it would do less, so we're just going to Flame Charge. Like, that's the one problem with Rock Smash. Is Rock Smash, as much as I love you, I can't use you. Double Edge will hit us very hard, but... Yikes. Okay. Fine, go ahead, do that. We'll Flame Charge. Yes. That Double Edge hit like a truck. I mean, it is Stab, so... Not surprising, but... That pretty much half hit me. We... weren't dead to crit there, because that only did like 69 damage. Nice. So yeah, we weren't dead there to crit, but Jesus. If that was a low roll and then it, if that was a low roll and that high roll crit, we were dead. Still though, again, we're going to go ahead and restore. We're running out of non-berry kind of heals, so it's a little unfortunate, but at the same time, it's kind of the reason we've got the berries. We could go and rest in the old woman's house, but I don't want to keep burning Horus. Like, I'd rather they just get burnt once, and then we deal with that for the rest of it. Still, who's up next? Kind of an annoying trainer, if I'm honest. Ace, Trainer, Brook. They will lead with a Gigalith that is sturdy. Explosion, Rock Slide, Bulldoze, and Stealth Rock with a Life Orb. So... kind of really fucking difficult for us to deal with. I feel like leading with Jormungandr is a good idea because I go Jormungandr, use that to tank the to intimidate it. Then what I could do is go into Zeus and try and predict the explosion, but like Gigalith is pretty pretty bulky. It's only rock type, so it is weak to steel. It's pretty strong in all honesty, so yeah, no real special defenses though to speak of, so maybe we could go for it. I mean, though, we are four times weak to bulldoze, which is a problem. Though, what if we give Zeus a, right, we're gonna do a little bit of thinking here, a little bit of theory crafting. So, I'm gonna calc this, because I do want to check. So, this is, right, where are you, trainer? 46 Gigalith. Okay. Gigalith, your level 46. Alright, now we get Zeus, who is level 54, so 54 there. Right, Flash Cannon will kill it, but Sturdy, obviously, we can't. Explosion, how much does Bulldoze do? Alright, Bulldoze will kill us, but if we have an Air Balloon, hang on, if I, well, first of all, we're Sturdy ourselves, so we can't die in one, which is fine. What I wanted to check was, so with an Evolve Light, it does between 54 and 64 damage. If it crits, then we still don't die. So we can definitely two-shot it with Flash Cannon. That's something we can do. Flash Cannon is a decent lead then. Spike Rocks get set up, we'll be okay. I'm just looking then at what else they've got in, because what they'll go into is anything with like a fighting type or a fire type move or an earth type. So that could be kind of tricky for us to deal with. But I think if we got that, then we'll we'll be okay. We'll kind of wing this one a bit, but I think Zeus going in and explosion won't do anywhere near enough damage. If explosion crits, explosion does 30% damage. So bulldoze the only move that it's got, and we can still survive it without too many issues. In terms of speed, we are faster. If I really want to, I could swap Evolite for something else, but I think the Evolite is probably the best bet that we've got. So let's Pokemon. Are you in the front? No, Zeus, get into the front. That's fine by me. The other thing we could do is we could do like an Intimidate, switch to predict the explosion, but if it goes for Rock Slide, then we have a problem. So Rock Slide. Yeah, well, we kind of don't actually. We kind of don't. So we could still go with that strategy. I'm not gonna, but we could. So here is the challenge. Oh, you and your Pokemon look quite strong. We simply must have a battle. And a battle we shall have. Ace Trainer Brook. Gonna send out a Gigalith like we thought. And like I said, Explosion, Bulldoze, Rock Slide, and... it is Rock Slide, right? Yeah, Explosion, Rock Slide, Bulldoze, Stealth Rocks. So our objective here is simple. We Flash Cannon once. And that, that puts it in sturdy range, which is fine by us. It uses Bulldoze. We're fine. Jesus Christ. My speed fell. So that was... Oh yes, it has a Life Orb. I forgot about that. Yikes. Okay, Bulldoze would have potentially killed there, but no, that's fine. You're not learning Dream Eater. Yeah. Keep old moves. Alright, my strategy was absolutely fantastic then. No, give up on... Oh, forgotten... Keep old moves. Yes, forget... Don't learn Dream Eater. You're not even keeping anything asleep. Right. Hippodon comes in next. This Hippodon has Sandstream, Rock Slide, Yawn, Earthquake, Crunch, and a Choice Scarf. Oh my god. 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 Tell me this thing goes for Earthquake here. It could, I think it could go for anything here, but if it is going to go for anything, then I feel like going into Jörmungandr here is probably a good option. I could also, no, I can't go into Akorokamui because ground poison might be a problem. Yeah, the Rock Slide. The Rock Slide's like the only thing we're slightly scared of here, but Hippodon's attack has fallen. Yes! Went for Earthquake! Now it's Choice Scarfed into using Earthquake. That's brilliant for us. This means that I could set up D-Dances here. Is there anything that I'm worried about having D-Dance stuff? No. I think we just D-Dance here for a couple... We D-Dance like twice because we know this thing's Choice Scarfed. Even if it switches out, we're fine. Hippodon use Earthquake. Yeah, it can't do anything. It can't do anything here. This is perfect for us. So we're just going to go ahead and set up like 2 D-Dances. Alright, you withdrew. That's okay. Barbaracle, Tough Claws, Shell Smash, Razor Shell, Rock Slide, Night Slash with a Focus Sash. We have 2 D-Dances up right now, so we know it's going to get at least one hit on us if it attacks. Buffeted by Sandstorm, then not. Right, okay, so we are 2 or 3 D-Dances in right now. We're 2 D-Dances in, so Jörmungandr, level 54, with 2 attack. Plus 2 attack and plus 2 speed. Your item is, I want to say a berry, I want to say, but that's fine. So we are looking at a Barbaracle with the moves. Shell Smash, Razor Shell, Rock Slide, Night Slash. Night Slash, Razor Shell, and okay, so Night Slash. If Night Slash is going to kill us 100%. Oh, wait, that's a level 100. I keep doing that. All right, Night Slash hits for 20%. Razor Shell hits for 19% at most. Yeah, and what is it? Rock Slide? Yeah, Rock Slide's going to be its best move. Rock Slide deals 64%. We are at 142 health, which is 81. So if it crits, it kills us. We know it's got a Focus Sash, but we know that we can kill it 100% with Aqua Tail or Bulldoze. Definitely. Ice Fang, we could get the flinch chance, and we know we've got to break a thing anyway, so we go Ice Fang here for the chance at a flinch and chance at a freeze. Yes! Oh, yes! 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 Fuck you! Fuck you! That's what we wanted. We wanted to break that. Now what we can do is we just go for Aqua Tail or Bulldoze, but neither matter. So we're just going to go Bulldoze because that's 100% accurate. We don't want to risk 10% chance of not hitting it. Fantastic. Fantastic. Oh my god, that was perfect. That was perfect. Yeah. Oh, he wasn't level 54, he was 53. Would that have made a big difference? No. Not in the slightest. Yeah, 54. Very nice. Okay, and the sandstorm's over now, which means Hippodon comes back in. Great. Sandstream's back on up, but the Hippodon has a choice scarf. We don't really care. Hippodon. Hippodon, blank set. Aqua Tail, again, it's level 100. So Aqua Tail does 200% damage. We can literally kill it twice, provided we hit this. And we do, which is good. Oh, the setup here, the setup was so good. The setup was so useful. Right, so that's that. Take a little bit more damage. We get buffeted again. Akoto Kamui level 53. Man, 125, which is 71% HP. Who's in next? Staraptor with Intimidate. Okay, U-turn, Close Combat, Brave Bird, and Roost with a Life Orb. Level 46. Staraptor. Blank set, we are plus one right now. This is level 46. Aqua Tail and Ice Fang both do 100% of its health. I don't think we've got to worry about anything else. At most, we should probably check, like, you've got Life Orb, you've got Brave Bird. So Brave Bird can kill us with the Sandstorm damage if it goes for it, and don't really have anything that can really tank it. So I think we just have to risk Aqua Tail here and hope that we don't miss. Oh my god. Why is it 90? Why is it base 90? Just make it like 75, 100. But no, that's good. That's good. That's good. Taylor Jr. is level 54 as well. Is that it? I don't know if that's it. I don't think that's it anyway. There may be one more. Sigilyph! Okay, Sigilyph. Yes, that's it almost. Magic Guard, Cosmic Power, Psycho Shift, Restored Power with a Flame Orb. This basically is something we're going to have to just kind of break through. So Sigilyph, blank set, 49. Aqua Tail, again, and Ice Fang both kill this thing completely. So we should be fine. I'm just so scared of that 10% miss. It's only 10%, but I'm just terrified it's going to fucking happen. It's a 1 in 10, and we only have 10 PP on that thing, so every time I look at it going, it should be a higher chance. I mean, it's not, but next up is an Aerodactyl. This is a Mega Aerodactyl with Unnerve, which returns to Tough Claws, Sky Drop, Rock Slide, Ice Fang, and Earthquake. At this point, level 47, Ice Fang and Aqua Tail do over 100%, and Pokemon, if I look at you and summary, check moves, both of these are 95, 90. I should be using Ice Fang. What am I doing? I should be 100% using Ice Fang here. Watch this miss and cost me Jormungandr. If that actually happens, I'm gonna fucking cry. And you guys get to watch that happen. There's a 5% chance we don't kill here. How many of you are screaming at me that Ice Fang is 95, not 90? Either way, Aerodactyl is done. Jesus fucking Christ. My nerves. I'm not a gambler. Honestly, I'm not a gambler. And I really wish this water was vodka right now. You didn't just look strong, you are strong. Fucking too right I am. Jesus Christ. But Jormungandr, though, what a fucking run-in! We started that off with Zeus for the Flash Cannon, hitting it to where it was going to be a brilliant use of Sturdy, coming in and then letting us get on out there for free. Still, though, fucking... I need a minute, and also to heal everyone up. Okay, so now we go ahead and get to move on. What have we got over here? That's right! a brand new route, Route 113. And May's here as well. Fantastic. Fan-friggin-tastic, eh? Isn't it just? But yeah, your Pokemon look pretty tired themselves. Don't take... I just healed everyone up! I hate you, May. You owe me like 20 berries. God damn it. Anyway, full armor is next. First thing we gotta do is go ahead and get through Route 113, which means new encounter. And so, with a new encounter, that means new chances for something, and I think that's it right away. I think that's it right away. Come on. Come on. Ooh, it could be. It could be. It so could be. But here's the thing. It's not. As much as it looks like this is the perfect place to pick up a fantastic tank right here, with a brilliant typing and brilliant defenses here, we're not using Skarmory. The Pokemon we're using is instead... Alright, here we are. The Pokemon that we are using. The game really wanted me to have a Skarmory. It offered me like 5 of them, but I said no because... How could I refuse the chance to bring back my favorite little dragon killer? That's right, our encounter here is a Klefki. Why? Because I fucking love this Pokemon. I think it's amazing. I genuinely think Klefki is one of the greatest, dumbest Pokemon of all time. Like I said, I have somewhere in, like, I'm pretty sure I still have a keyring of a Klefki. It's actually, like, just my favorite Pokemon in all of existence. So it's either Prankster or Magician. Either way, what we want to do is check what bloody moves it learns. So at 39, it will have Imprison, Mirror Shot, Foul Play, and Torment. Mirror Shot, we're fine with everything. Doesn't have Draining Kiss, so we're gonna have to spend a point to get that back, but it's okay because we can Thunder Wave this, and we'll be fine. So now, let's get the, Catch Calc. We are in Omega Ruby. Klefki, you're level 39, and you are paralyzed. In an Ultra Ball, you have a 39% chance, you know? I think that's pretty good. I think that is indeed pretty good. We don't really want to hit this thing. I don't trust me. I don't trust anything not to go wrong. So, no, I shouldn't be putting you in an Ultra Ball. I should be putting you in a Premier Ball. Oh, please break out of this one. Please break out of this one. Please break out. I don't want you in this stinky ball. No, don't get in the stinky ball. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Used in prison. We don't share any moves. I want you in a Premier Ball. I don't care if it's a drastically lower chance. We're putting you in a Premier Ball. In fact, I'm going to check on the calc, Pokemon damage calculator, shiny imported, Zeus level 55 versus Klefki at level 39. Okay, so Tri Attack will not kill it. Hang on, let's assume zero IHP, zero special. Alright, so if it crits, it'll do between 69 and 81%. So Tri Attack here cannot kill, it cannot burn, it cannot freeze, it cannot paralyze because we've already paralyzed it, so that's good for us. How does it feel, Klefki? Now you're the one paralyzed who can't do anything. Yeah, that's fine. No crit, and that puts it at, you know, about 70% health. So let's say you're at 70%, 33% chance. We'll take that. We will take that, right? Pokeball. I said that Premier Balls are for my favorite Pokemon. And you most certainly are up there in my favorites. So get in the damn ball. I don't care. You're getting in the ball. We can sit here and do this all night. I've got all the time in the world. Get in the ball. One, two, three. Yes. Klefki has been added to the Pokedex. And I am officially fucking ecstatic. Hell fucking yeah, we got a cleft key! I don't give a shit if there was a choice of a scammery! This little motherfucker right here! Thunderwave, Calm Mind, Draining Kiss! Fucking... Yes! Give me that shit! Inject it right into my fucking veins! Yes, we'll give you a nickname! And if you watched X and Y playthrough, you know damn well what this thing's gonna be named! That's right, we're returning back to Portunus, the Roman god of keys and doors. Also, livestock and ports, but keys and doors. No better a name, and no better a time to get fucking Cleft Key. Hell yes, I'm ecstatic. However, as ecstatic as I am, we're going to have to go ahead and end off this video here, because next time we have Route 113 to traverse. Make our way on over to Fall Arbor Town and see just what's going on over there. If you have enjoyed this video, then do be sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more, and to share this stuff so people know that it exists. My name has been Supersonic Blur. You guys have been a fantastic audience, and I shall see you all next time.